Welcome to Anish for You, and you are watching Neverwinter PC. I played this game for last 2 years, and it is one of hell nice MMORPG. I like many aspect of this game, and I really enjoy playing that game. I already created like 15-16 character, different build, different type of race, different skill and everything. And recently I start thinking about one thing. The game maybe became a pay to win game. Although it is a really good game from a not so reputed publishers, but I like this game very much, and recently a lot of new updates are really push the envelope even further. They're introducing this mod 19. They're introducing a really great area, Avernus. This update brings you a lot of new place to explore, new faction, demon and devil battle and all that. So I really like it. But the problem is the game goes in a very slippery slope. The game's going to become a pay-to-win game, and very shortly it will lose a lot of good player because of that, because veterans are playing for like 6 and 7 years, 8 years, almost 5-6 years veterans are playing this game, and as per the progress goes, a normal 2-month-old player can easily use their money and outshine those veteran player, and that's very dangerous for a MMORPG, because when you ignore those veteran players grinding, and if you're giving new player a lot of items, and if you give them a choice to buy out every single thing on the game, then it will become really really bad, and I will show you how it going to be so bad. So there is a main aspect of the game. What you get out of the game, or what you how you power up your character. So as you know, this is the armor and all those things. So this is armor, this 4 piece of armor, then these 2 piece of shirt and trouser, 2 ring, 1 neck and 1 waist. So these armors are armors you can get it from quest, doing quest and getting those seal, or doing dungeons and then getting seal and exchange those seal for your armor and weaponry. Weaponry you can get these weapon or any other weapon from particular that module. This is a old module game, old module gear, not this module gear. So this is an old module gear. I get it from expedition, and this is actually I get it for free because I get it from a box. So out of the box it is a free item, as same as this electric this neck item and this belt item. So actually everything is free. So what about money, or what about money spending and all that? Every item is required some type of enchantment. It is a weapon enchantment, armor enchantment, and those are really costly. The top grade armor enchantment and weapon enchantment are very costly up until recently, though, because they are introducing I'll talk about it later. But these weapon enchantment and armor enchantment, those are very costly, and those are taking time. People are grinding a normal enchantment to higher and higher level until they became the top of the line enchantment or highest rank enchantment. So that's how you grind in this game, because there is no other way upgrade your upgrade your item or upgrade your character without using those enchantment. If you lose all those enchantment, you are really powerless, because same armor, these armor are dropping like really frequently. Any armor in this game, you can get it easily. So armor is not a problem. So what set you apart from any other player is your enchantment. Those are the items you get. Like here it is, my very bad rank 9 enchantment, bulk shield enchantment. You know why it is rank 9? Because I don't have that money. Because I buy epic mount or a legendary mount. So for this legendary mount, I spend all the crystal and I don't have enough to for the bulk for other enchantment. I gave my normal, I think I had previously had a I had something else. It is rank 9 enchantment, but rank 10, I think I had rank 10 enchantment previously, but it's not bulk shield, because bulk shield is very costly at that time. So I can manage only a rank 9 bulk shield enchantment for extra defensive power and all that. So these enchantments are really important. And then the power, it is free because it is your power. You don't have to grind it or anything. It just as it is as you level up. But this is what makes a lot of difference. Actually, you can see I spent 71 boon point on this character. I completed every quest for this last Avernus quest. So without mod 19, I completed every possible campaign and unlocked those boons, and they give me extra stat like 1250 power. So it is really a lot of power is there. So 4000 and 5000 power only in these four category, and other category you can choose a lot of different portion. You already know that. So booms takes a lot of time. Actually, you are grinding for the booms. So let's think about it. Can you buy these booms? Yes, you can buy these booms. If you're a 2 months player, can you buy these booms? Yes, you can buy these booms. You can buy each and every boon. I think like last one or one on two campaign, you cannot buy it. But other than that, you can buy anything, or you can buy every other campaigns. So after that, I have to summon my companion. Oh, I cannot summon my companion because I am in a car. So in here, you had your companion. So you had your companion, a lot of companions are there, and you have the runestone. Do you know when I get this runestone? This one rank 15 runestone recently. They gave two rank 15 enchantment or runestones gift. So I get those two and I buy this one in mod 19 because it is became very cheap. Yes, it is, it became very cheap. It is almost like half of the price. So I'm talking about this all again and again. So this is companion gear. You cannot find it on any, you cannot purchase it. You have to do grinding to get those item. But the runestone slotted here, those are purchasable. So everything is purchasable right now. This is mount, different mount, and now it is legendary mount, this is epic, and this is normal blue mount. I think I had blue mount, and then the green one, and then the normal. You can buy it from normal currency. So there is a lot of different types of mount, and they give you a lot of power or a lot of stat. The legendary mount give me 10,000 power. The normal epic mount gives us 5,000 or different types of power, like 5,000 movement speed, defense, 5,000 defense deflection. And so mount also very important for your stat, for your total stat. So you can see I have to 26,000 item level, not here, but I have normally. If I leave the car, I have 26,000, my item level is 26,000, and these 26,000 is basically given by those stat, those enchantments, those mount, those companion gear, compounding runestone give us a power, and those items. So let's see a chart. So this is the chart. This is the armor, weapon, artifact, enchantment, boons, companion, runestone, companion gear, mount, insignia, and all that. So this is the all item which increase your stat or increase your character or make your character better. So those are the items, those are the things. So what you can buy from Zen Market or buy with your normal money. So you can buy almost everything. How? So I'm showing you the Zen Market. So on sale, so I'm not talking about on sale, events, no, VIP, I will talk about it later. So first of all, they give us bag, different types of bag. It is not a big problem. Every game gives us a table bag. It is not a very big problem, but you can see legendary insignia pack. You can get your legendary insignia. You can just buy it. Yes, obviously there is RNG applied, but you can get your legendary insignia. You can get your enchantment or refinement, and then you get I think that's it for here. Then this is lockbox key. Lockbox key is also very important. You can buy those lockbox key and open those lockbox. So this is a pack. So these are normal pack, defenders pack, and expedition. So there are Geth race pack, moon elf race pack, Rengard Drow race pack, and metal I think dragonborn race pack. I already buy it, so it is not showing here. So there is a 4 unlockable race. It's also not a big problem because a lot of game also locked a race in a paywall, so it is not a problem. But this is a big problem. You can buy campaign bundle. You can buy campaign. It is not a problem. So you can buy acquisition incorporation. So if you see here, this is a normal without acquisition incorporation. So this is mod 16. You can buy this one. It gives you couple of boons, 4 boons. So like that. Then elemental level, I don't think the elemental level is there. in the category. So then Jungle of Chalt, written to category. So then Jungle of Chalt, and this one, Ravenloft, this one, and then the bundle gives you Maze Engine, Surrender, Underdark, Dead Ring. Not Underdark, but Dead Ring, Storm King Thunder. So this one, and the other one gives you Underdark, Ravenloft, Clock Assassin, and Jungle of Chalt. So other than Avernus, Undermountain, and Path of the Fallen, so it is also in Avernus chapter mode. So these three you can say these three mod or these three chapter are not unlockable right now, but those are going to be unlockable if there is a new mod is coming, new chapter is coming, then those also get unlocked by the Zen. So 7000 Zen means 1700 rupees per, so it is, you can call it $10 per 1000 Zen. So it is $70 pack, and it gives you five piece of item, and this is also 7000. So 5 5 10, so from 13 there is 10 already given. Actually one is not given, elemental evil is not given, but it is very easy and it is very low leveled campaign, not bothered for that. So campaigns are given, so boons are given, then mounts are epic and normal mount, but they recently sell legendary mount also. So mount, every category of mount they are giving you, then almost a lot of companion also given by Zen Market, and then profession I don't want to talk about it. And then you can even level up your character if you buy these $50 chest, $50 item, but it is not relevant right now. And then appearance, so if you consider all those and then consider the keys or unlock keys, those are also very pricey. This is like $1 per enchantment key, so not easy and not very cheap. If you are taking a VIP, it costs you $10 and it gives you 30 lockbox key and 1 month of different facility. Like I had my 12 rank 12 VIP benefit is not available right now or active right now. So it gives you summoning bank and all that. So there is a lot of help you get if you buy these VIP. But if you look at the lockbox, you can easily see what is the difference right now between previously and right now. So inspect this box. So this is a very old lockbox. So it gives you a legendary mount. It's a giver because this is a prime or the main object you're getting from a lockbox. So this is the main thing you aim for when you open a lockbox. But it's very rare to drop a legendary mount. I think like my 12 months or like 15 months I played with VIP, I get 3 legendary mount. So the rate is very very low. So I think yes, 2 or 3, and then you get an epic mount of the same type, and then get a artifact, and then normal items and all that. So it is not very good, not very good, because there is R&D involved, so you can get very bad item, you can really get a very crappy item. And another thing is important, this is Treadbird Jackpot, so Treadbird Jackpot also gives you each and every time you open a lockbox, you get some of Treadbird Jackpot or Treadbird. If you get like 2 or 4 or 10 or 20 or something like that. But now look at the new box. So obviously get a mount, and this is account bound, so this is really good, and it is really good to get a account bound or something like that. Then really costly artifact, really costly, it is really costly artifact, a nice companion upgrade token and all that. Now let's see here, enchantment stone, you have to run certain bosses or certain dungeons to get those items, but you can get it from this lockbox also. You get weapon enchantment, armor enchantment, different types of refinement or enchantment stone and all that. So you get a lot of stuff right now, and not only that, they are giving you a different types of item like companion upgrade token and companion token pack. So there is a lot of item right now, so it makes these packs much more valuable than those previous pack, because these packs gives you a lot of variety item, and you can get really good item out of it, other than the mount. Obviously mount is a giver, but without the mount there also are a lot of items also included to make it more appealing to the user, so they really stop grinding the game, because there is no reason to grind this game, because you need to grind your 15 character and you get something like rank 5 enchantment or 10 rank 5 enchantment and all that, and within these 17 character other people are just using lock boxes, and they get much more higher item or higher grade item or even more item of the same grade item. So it is really difficult to understand. These games are just making the game just making the trend. Like I'm showing you also the trade bar section. So
hail, adventurer! Interested in parting with any of your trade bars?
Yes.
I have many fine goods.
Okay, I know that. So in the trademark mansion, it also gives you previously it is like for show, nothing is there, not a good things are there, but right now you can get the highest rank possible runestone and the highest rank possible enchantment. So really it is really dumb thing, and I think it is very absurd. So you can get like, this is really costly item, empowerment runestone rank 13, or if you're considering not runestone because those are companion gear, so these are dark, this not radiant enchantment, those are highest grade enchantment. This is a top grade enchantment, then you can just buy it. Yes, you can just buy it. No hard feelings. You can just purchase a lot of boxes, and you open them. And if you don't find any enchantment, high grade enchantment, you cumulative these trademark, and you can just buy that rank radiant enchantment of this is the one of the most costly item, one of the most costly item in this game, but now it is cheap. Although these bonding runestone, those two items, the bonding runestone and the radiant enchantment 15 rank 15, both rank 15 are cost tremendous. I cannot afford any radiant enchantment or any bonding runestone or rank 15. I can't afford that, but after the update I can easily buy two or three of them, so the price really drop drastically. And it also shows you that you can purchase each and everything just by doing payment. So again, look at the list. Armor you cannot buy it or from Zen or Lockbox or Trade Bar, but you can get it from grinding. So that's it. Then weapon enchantment. So weapon enchantment you cannot get it from Zen Market or Lockbox, but you can get it from Trade Bar. So if you look at the Trade Bar, then you get the equipment, and you can get each individual category's equipment here. So you can get the weapon from your money. Artifact, yes, you can get artifact. How you get it? So the Trade Bar also gives you artifact. This is a top of the line artifact. These two are really good artifact. Those are not that good, but these two are really good. This is one of the most costly artifact out there. 1 million AD or 1.5 million AD or 2 million AD. It goes something like that, but I think the price is going to be degraded right now. So you can get these artifact. So enchantment, you get this enchantment, you already see from Zen Market you can get the enchantment, and then from Lockbox you get also, Trade Bar you can also get it, and from grinding obviously you can get it going from grinding, but it takes you much longer. Booms you can get it from Zen Market, and you can also do it by grinding. Companion you can get it from everywhere, you can get it, get your companion from everywhere. Runestone, companion and mount is somewhat different, but because you can increase your capacity, increase your mount quality by spending money, or not money, in-game currency on them. So I don't have any problem with companion. Runestone you can get it from Zen Market, obviously there is no sale is going on, but you can definitely get it from Lockbox and Trade Bar, so you can get it from with your money. Companion gear you cannot get it from anywhere without grinding the game, so right now it is only from grinding, same as armor. Mount is interesting thing, because legendary mount you cannot get it, get a legendary mount from anywhere, not from anywhere. So I think also epic mount also, but I think epic mount can drop from different bosses and all that. So legendary mount never drop from normal in game. They can only be obtained from these pay or these lock boxes, so you have to pay for the legendary mount, but other than that you can get a blue mount or the green mount or normal, even epic mount. I think epic mount also dropped, so I don't remember it correctly, but I think the epic mount also you can get it here from normal drop from bosses and all that. And insignia you can get it from normal way. Also there is a lot of different way you can upgrade. Previously it is a different way, now it is a different way. And now the mountain insignia you can see here. Mountain insignia, you get a lot of mount, but insignia, those are really costly previously, but not right now. And they, you can get a lot of epic insignia and dominant one, because gives you power. So you can get a lot of insignia with your money. So that's it. From without only armor and companion gear, without these two items you can get each and everything from the game. And I'm telling you one thing again, if you spend money you can convert Zen or normal currency or your dollar or rupees or anything, you can exchange your normal currency to Zen, and then you can Zen to our normal astral diamond, what we use in the in-game currency as an in-game currency. So you can convert it and then you can buy it from auction house and all that. Companion gear, you can get some companion gear, and you can also get some bad you can say armor, bad armor and all that. So you can wear those armor, use those enchantment and rune stone and all that, and beat a boss and get a good armor, and then just swap those enchantment with it. So this is, there is also way without playing this game you can just become a top rank character. Yes, there is a way. If you wish to grind your card even more, you can just go do that, spend thousand of dollar and become a legend overnight, and forget about our 2 year old normal player who doesn't spend that much money, but spend a lot of money, but doesn't spend that much money. They wish to grind the game and they didn't get any item or anything from these changes. So this is a very slow moving car. Really slow moving. My wire machine is here. So that's it. Thank you for watching this video. If you like it, please hit the like button, and if you like Neverwinter video, tell us on comment. I can easily make I wish to make a lot of different Neverwinter video, and thanks for watching and see you next time. Goodbye.